As of June 23rd of 2025, there are currently 47 volcanoes which are actively erupting around the planet, a total which is one less than were erupting last week. One of these erupting volcanoes, marking the highest point on the island of Java, is Indonesia's Semeru volcano. Semeru has been producing a continuous eruption since 2017, which during 2021 involved a 16-kilometer-long pyroclastic flow. Activity since then has mostly been less substantial, involving smaller partial collapses of its growing lava dome and volcanic explosions that generate mostly shorter-reaching pyroclastic flows. And now, here are this week's top volcano-related news stories. In Japan, the alert level was raised at the populated volcanic island of Miyakejima due to a combination of a swarm of earthquakes and ground deformation being detected. Meanwhile, in Hawaii, another round of spectacular more than 1,000-foot-high lava fountaining was observed at Kilauea Volcano's summit, once again leading to large crowds. And, in what is this week's top story, a major eruption occurred from Indonesia's Lewotobi volcano, resulting in one fatality and more than 13 square kilometers of ground being incinerated by superheated pyroclastic flows. This major explosive eruption began at 5:35 p.m. local time on June 17th, when pressure that had been building underneath a newly formed plug was violently released. As car-sized boulders of rock were ejected, a mushroom cloud continued to rise, eventually reaching an altitude of 10,000 meters or 32,808 feet. Simultaneously, since part of the eruption column was too dense to rise on the buoyant column of hot air, it collapsed back to the ground, generating a series of pyroclastic flows which advanced in all directions at high speeds. These superheated gas currents quickly incinerated everything in a 1 kilometer radius, but lobes of the pyroclastic flow would continue much further to the north and east-northeast, reaching up to 4,560 meters away. In only 100 seconds, an area of 13.45 square kilometers or 5.19 square miles had been obliterated, but thankfully this did not include any structures. Then, 15 minutes later, a second more powerful explosion occurred, sending a plume of ash to an altitude of 16,154 meters or 53,000 feet. This represented Lewotobi's fourth major sub-plinian eruption since November 2024 and caused ash to rain down as far away as the town of Mamir. The lack of direct fatalities is owed to the volcanic plug being successfully detected and the issuing of a 7-8 kilometer exclusion zone in all directions 2.5 hours before the explosive event began. Meanwhile, in Hawaii, cyclical lava fountaining of the Kilauea Shield volcano continued this week, with its 26th episode attracting large crowds. This occurred after an 8-day-long period of no lava effusion, with molten rock finally beginning to spew from the two summit vents at 11:26 p.m. local time on June 19th. Eruptive activity slowly intensified over the night hours, with sustained lava fountaining initiating at 1:40 a.m. Lava fountain heights then increased to as much as 330 meters or 1,083 feet, adding additional tephra to the southwest. Eruptive activity then decreased in the morning, with the north vent ceasing its activity at 10:07 a.m. and the south vent stopping 18 minutes later. I estimate that around 3.9 million cubic meters of lava was erupted, and now, in my opinion, we might expect episode 27 to begin before the end of July 1st. And, in Japan, for the first time in more than a decade, the alert level was raised at the Miyakejima volcano, rising from white to yellow. This change was made on June 17th in response to both a swarm of earthquakes beneath its summit and the detection of increased ground deformation. However, activity rapidly declined by the late afternoon of the same day and has returned to near background levels in the time since. For hundreds of years, Miyakejima had erupted every few decades, sometimes more than a century apart, but that changed in 2000. Due to the removal of a large volume of underlying magma to the west below the ocean floor, a deeper caldera formed at its summit, and almost yearly eruptions followed over the next 10 years. Oftentimes, after a caldera collapse, a volcano can remain unusually active for a time, with it being unknown whether such a period is truly over quite yet in the long run at this volcanic island populated by 2,500 people. Here is a quick list of all the world's volcanoes which are currently erupting. Additionally, here are some volcanoes showing signs of unrest which are not erupting as of the recording of this video on June 22nd of 2025. As a final note, I would like to thank my new patron, Edward Hot App, for supporting my work.